Tonight, Flagstar is warning customers their personal information, including social security numbers, may have been stolen in a ransomware breach.
In focus, shares of UK's Metro Bank, which were briefly suspended twice early Thursday after a volatile session over reports it is seeking to raise millions to bolster its finances.
Analysts insist that the financial system is in shambles, and they have a lot of evidence to show for it. Yet for the longest time, we have continued to move like all was well. That is until we started seeing banks like the SVB shut down and depositors panicking hastily to secure their money. Now, industry experts are saying this is only the beginning. Today, we have troubling news from two giants as well. Chase Bank and Bank of America are going through difficult times, and this cloud seems void of a silver lining. What exactly is going on? Let's see some important news across the sector. In 2019, UK regulators found an accounting error in Metro Bank's loan book, costing them a pretty terrible fall. The company, listed in 2016, was demoted from the FTSE 250 index in September 2019 and has yet to return since. Due to the error, it recorded £213 million, $274.49 million, in deposit outflows in September 2019, and its stock fell nearly 90%. After the lender disclosed the accounting error that had underreported its exposure to higher risk loans by almost £1 billion. Since then, Metro Bank has been working tirelessly to regain stability, but it seems constantly be laden with woes. On the 5th of October, 2023, it was reported by major news outlets that the troubled Metro Bank was considering raising money by selling shares. This move was being considered as a means to convince regulators that it was stable enough to be trusted and capable of holding less cash against the mortgage risk. This was after the bank founded by American billionaire Vernon Hill had its share price go down drastically by over 50% this month alone, thanks to the decision by the Bank of England to deny its application for the use of internal models to assess the risk of its mortgages. Metro Bank's proposal would have saved them from the pressure of their capital burden, or at least lessened it. With very limited options to shore up its balance sheet before 2025, when a debt of £350 million worth of debt comes up for refinancing, the bank took its chances and raised money from shares. Metro Bank has successfully bolstered its financial foundation, securing nearly £925 million in the wake of a decline in its share price. This substantial infusion of funds encompasses fresh capital injection, debt restructuring, and a substantial contribution from Spaldy Investments. This strategic move coincides with the bank's intent to divest up to £3 billion worth of residential mortgages, signaling a shift in focus towards alternative mortgage solutions and commercial lending. The £925 million funding initiative has been devised to fortify the bank's balance sheet and enhance its potential for sustained profitability and growth. This blueprint entails a £325 million infusion of new capital, featuring £150 million from new investors and £175 million from MREL issuance. Additionally, £600 million has been earmarked for the refinancing of debt. EO Daniel Frumkin regards this as a pivotal juncture for Metro Bank, leveraging the groundwork laid down in the preceding 3 years to ensure sustained profitability. His objective is to elevate Metro Bank to the forefront of the UK's community banking sector, providing a comprehensive range of digital and physical banking services to its dedicated clientele, numbering 2.7 million customers. However, according to Gary Greenwood, a banking analyst at Shore Capital, the arrangement seems to safeguard the bank's near-term viability, but is, regrettably, a painful rescue operation, impacting both shareholders and bondholders. But Metro Bank is not the only one facing many woes. Flagstar Bank has reported its third data breach in 3 years. Now that's some crazy news. The bank has issued a cautionary alert, revealing that more than 800,000 American customers have fallen victim to a cyber attack that resulted in the theft of their personal information. This security breach was attributed to a third-party service provider. Flagstar, currently under the ownership of the New York Community Bank, is based in Michigan. Prior to its acquisition last year, it was one of the largest banks in the United States, boasting total assets exceeding $31 billion. In a data breach notification dispatched to affected customers, it was explained that Flagstar's exposure to the breach was indirect, arising from its association with Fiserv, a vendor responsible for handling payment processing and mobile banking services. In the extensive data breach incidents known as the CLOP Move It Transfer Data Theft Attacks, Fiserv fell victim to a breach that affected over 64 million individuals and approximately 2,000 organizations across the globe, as reported by Emsisoft. The attackers capitalized on a zero-day vulnerability found in the MoveIt transfer product to infiltrate Fiserv systems. Subsequently, they pilfered customer data belonging to Flagstar, which Fiserv had on record to facilitate its services. While the specific categories of compromised data have been concealed in the example data breach notification letters, information available on Maine's data breach portal indicates that, at a minimum, names and social security numbers were among the stolen information by the threat actors. The total number of Flagstar Bank customers affected by this incident in the United States is 837,390. But what is simply shocking about this is that it is not the first time, and not even the second time, but the third. In March 2021, the company revealed that it had fallen victim to a breach orchestrated by the Klopp ransomware group. This attack originated from their intrusion into the Excellion file transfer server back in January of that same year. Based on the data samples shared by the ransomware gang, the attackers successfully exfiltrated customer and employee information, encompassing details such as names, addresses, phone numbers, tax records, and social security numbers. Subsequently, in June 2022, Flagstar disclosed another security breach affecting its corporate network. This incident impacted over 1.5 million of its customers in the United States. The data that was compromised in this instance included, at the very least, names and social security numbers. The current breach is still being investigated, and it is unclear how far-reaching the effects may be. However, the bank has launched investigations into the incident, and as per ReSecurity, a cybersecurity firm headquartered in Los Angeles, the data has not yet been exposed on the dark web. Instead, it is being made available for sale within private underground networks. However, it is likely that malicious individuals may seek to profit on a larger scale by vending personal identifiable information, PII, and payment data. This incident re-emphasizes the importance of strict regulations on banking institutions, especially because of how lapses could potentially affect millions of people. Regulators are no longer taking any chances, and US Fed's top regulatory officials are discussing sweeping capital rules. On the 9th of October, the top regulatory official of the US Federal Reserve staunchly defended a comprehensive proposal aimed at revamping bank capital regulations when addressing the country's largest bank lobby on Monday. He asserted that the advantages of a larger financial buffer outweigh any additional costs that banks may incur. Michael Barr, the Fed's vice chair for supervision, emphasized that the intricate Basel endgame proposal, which seeks to revamp the way banks assess the capital they need to safeguard against potential losses, is expected to have a relatively minor impact on banks' lending costs. The proposal primarily concentrates on other activities, such as trading. This proposal is designed to implement international capital standards that were established by the Basel Committee on Banking Supervision in response to the financial crisis of 2007 to 2009. Since its introduction in July, banks have vigorously opposed the plan, rallying support in Congress and launching advertising campaigns. They argue that it will negatively affect mortgage borrowers, funding for environmentally friendly projects, and the broader economy. Contrary to these concerns, Barr counters that similar warnings were voiced by banks when regulators imposed stricter rules following the financial crisis. Nevertheless, the U.S. banking system has remained robust and the economy has continued to grow. A strong capital foundation ensures that lenders can withstand economic downturns and unforeseen risks. The recent failures of institutions like Silicon Valley Bank and others this year highlight the necessity of fortifying the system. In the meantime, JP Morgan Chase Bank, Bank of America, and Goldman Sachs are currently facing hefty fines to the tune of billions of dollars. The Commodity Futures Trading Commission, CFTC, is penalizing these banks for their inadequate reporting of millions of transactions in the swaps market. They have been mandated to pay fines of $15 million, $8 million, and $30 million, respectively. Goldman Sachs is fined due to unprecedented failures in swap data reporting and the disclosure of pre-trade mid-market marks. The CFTC stipulates that swap dealers, such as Goldman Sachs, must furnish PTMMs to enable counterparties to make well-informed decisions when entering swaps. This rule originates from the Dodd-Frank Act of 2010. The Dodd-Frank Wall Street Reform and Consumer Protection Act, commonly called the Dodd-Frank Act, is a financial reform legislation enacted in the United States in 2010. It was passed in response to the global financial crisis of 2007 to 2008, which had severe consequences for the US and global economies. The primary goals of the Dodd-Frank Act were to prevent another financial crisis and protect consumers from abusive financial practices. Despite being in effect for over 13 years, the CFTC alleges that Goldman Sachs violated this regulation on over 1 million occasions. Furthermore, the CFTC believes that Goldman's correction of over 20 million swaps thus far significantly underestimates the actual extent of their swap data reporting deficiencies. Additionally, on over 1 million occasions since 2013, Goldman has provided counterparties with inaccurate PTMMs or failed to provide them. In the case of JP Morgan, the CFTC found that the bank failed to report pertinent data related to foreign exchange swaps. According to the CFTC's announcement, the bank omitted over 150,000 constituent FX spot transactions and incorrectly categorized certain transactions, effectively leaving them unreported. However, the CFTC noted that Goldman, Bank of America, and JP Morgan Chase provided substantial cooperation during the investigation, resulting in reduced civil monetary penalties. The Dodd-Frank Act and several other regulations being imposed on financial institutions remain controversial, with some arguing that they place excessive burdens on the industry. In contrast, others believe they have been instrumental in safeguarding the financial system and consumers. The many bank woes detailing inefficiency and lack of stability are a stark reminder that the financial industry is far from immune to crises despite strict regulatory scrutiny. It appears that we are in a sinking ship. These challenges demand a continuous commitment to comprehensive regulatory oversight to protect customers' interests and maintain the integrity of the financial system. As we move forward, the coming days seem riddled with uncertainty regarding the fate of the economy and the financial industry. There must be radical changes and fast.